regulation of motor system by distribution of pressure under the control of biomechanical tests in orthodontia and pediatrics, manual therapy and medicine. Let me thank the organizers for inviting me to such representative symposium and the Professor Dudin and the audience. My presentation is called Regulation of the Motor System of the Human Beings by Individually Aimed Distribution of Pressure on the Body with the Control of Biomechanical Tests in Orthopedics, Manual Medicine, Orthodontia and Podiatry. The name is so long because the techniques I use have only one thing in common. They exist in physiology, but they are used by different practitioners and different professional groups. I represent the Russian Association of Manual Medicine, and I'm also a consultant of the orthodontic system. Certainly, orthopedy means direct and correct child and the bringing up of this child. In my presentation, I will be using some terms from physics, mechanics, biology, physiology, and clinical practice. Because this is the basis, the general basis of medicine as an applied science compared to all these fundamental disciplines. A few words about my teachers who brought me up. Алексей Самаруков. You can see him in the upper right, head of the Russian Association of the Manual Medicine, the person who heads the scientific center at the Russian Center of Medical Curatology and Restorative Medicine, a person who is the founder of the Russian School of Manual Therapy, Anatoly Niborsky, who was the first one to learn manual therapy in Russia. He learned it in Prague in under Levitt in the Institute of Neurosurgery. And certainly Dr. Starikov, Sergei Starikov, who is the person who in our military medicine is using the techniques of both physiotherapy and manual therapy. He is the head specialist on physiotherapy of the military forces of the Russian Federation. And Vladimir Nechaev, the person who has brought to Russia and is using very highly functional technology, very highly physiological technology of the feet orthosis. The manual therapy in Russia inherits the principles defined by the international community. It uses diagnostics, first and foremost physical and manual diagnostics, therapy, mechanical and reflex one, and prevention of diseases, as well as involvement of the patient into the therapeutic activities without the use of any rough methods and techniques. Technical identity and terminological incorrectness in manual therapy is very important, because what we are using and what conservative orthopedy negates as of today, namely the use of physiological techniques for diagnosis and treatment, is an important part, and we may and have to use it without negating this possible assistance to the patients. In Voronezh, the city I represent, we have a conference conducted twice a year dedicated to the manual, muscle and skeletal medicine and therapy that unites the doctors of different specialities who all try to impact the locomotive system. They are physiotherapists, orthopedists, and you see Albina Čižek-Palejka here, a medical doctor professor who uses in her practice those tests, functional tests, that are becoming more and more generally accepted. They permit orthopedy, and we can investigate mechanical objects by corresponding mechanical methods at the bedside of the patient. Each person, when looking into the sky, Milky Way, this is the birth of the Milky Way, a picture, but great scientists perceive the world through their ideas, and this is one of the scientists, Rudolf Magnus, who was the founder of the reflex systems and how to change the position of one part of the body and how this impacts the other parts of the body. Also, Charles Sherrington should be mentioned, and integrative physiology. Thanks to Magnus Klein's works, we may learn how the human beings walk, stand, and how the body is functioning. And that all these are reflexes. That's what Pavlov said, and his one of his disciples, Bernstein, created the physiology of activity. And kinematic cycle notion, Peter Anohin, the person who has created the theory of functional systems, and applied this theory and developed it in terms of the theory of functional systems. The system, only such a complex of selectively involved components, may be called a system, that in which the interactions are of the interaction of the components is focused on receiving some meaningful results. All this should be used in terms of the locomotive system. Muscles, is this meat or organ? The muscles are organs, and they are very complex organs. In order to understand how we can impact them and which part of them can we impact, we have to know them well. Modern physiology knows how muscles work. Each muscle consists of three groups of motion units. The fiber, muscle fiber, is only a part of the substrate that we need to analyze. We have a neuron, a motor neuron, and muscle fiber are one whole. More often, when we speak about the muscle nowadays, we mainly speak about the part that is the mechanical part. If we speak about neuron, we look at it as an electrical system. But we have a wonderful group of motion units that are slow ones, but they work forever. The only thing they need is the oxygen, and due to them, we have certain shape of body in terms of scoliosis and the so-called distortions. We have to speak about this motion units, their physiology, and how to impact them and to treat the patients. This group, namely speed and force, they do not work forever. the fatigue, or they get tired, especially the false ones, in 2 minutes. They need oxygen and glucose. How we can train force and strength? The balance that the human being usually carries with him, so training of strength is not training the strongest, but we have to train the reflexes, how quickly all the moving units will be involved into motion. The discovery of this century is the discovery of mechanical sensitive ionic channels that influence onto the function, state and structure of cells. This is the basis of orthopedy, when not drugs but pressure may change the metabolism. This can be achieved, and we can impact the whole system from different points. Maybe we shall move on to the results, because it's high time for us to finish. Yes, please. This is an important part. We impact very important biological zones, feet and mouth cavity. We can impact these zones and change the reflexes of the trunk and the posture of the trunk by doing this. From one small zone by the interneurons, we can impact the whole system. For control, we'll be using the flexion test. And here you can see the results of this test. You can see the phenomena of blocking, where the curves in scoliotic patients. In this place, all the muscle fibers and all the motion units of both the skeleton and blood vessels are working simultaneously in the same mode. They respond little onto the elongation and flexion. They remain blocked. The technology consists of the following stages. Diagnostic stage, we have to look for this afferent receptor fields that cause deactivation of the functions of the motion system. Investigation zones, trunk and extremities, the mouth cavity and feet. Therapy stage, correction on site, and then check and control with the same mechanical tests. We used and are continuing to use some other types of the orthomanual therapy, and you see we try to achieve even distribution of pressure onto the body. Shoes, orthoses of feet, individual, made of materials created by Chert de Becker, and the threshold has to be selected. And the materials called so-called pinball.
Well, these mechanical methods managed to reveal or to improve symmetry, and also the patient felt better. Here comes the question: how can we confirm it using different methods? So we started a study in Aganyolko, and some had cups, some had pads. So we've chosen the orthosis braces and phartotic pads. Besides the functional tests, we used MRI, topography, stabilometry, and other methods. That's briefly about the Mio braces and the kappas. If the tongue and lips muscles are tense, the muscles behind are relaxed. Thus, the position of the head and neck are improved, and this influences the whole body. Please switch on the movie. Now we'll continue. We can't start the movie, sorry. Okay, let us not do it now. Please tell us the gist of our presentation. The gist is as follows. These technologies may be used, but there's a big difference between the biomechanical studies and the studies habitual in the clinical practice. There's correlation between the three methods, but we see modification only when we do direct study of the part of motion unit. This is motor neuron, and thus this is the best method of study. Stabilometry and computer optical studies are not very good for assessment of motion units activity. So the general conclusion is as such. Let me tell you that the orthosis study has only started, and we do not have, well, for you to see modifications, you need 3 months. We are at the initial stage yet. We saw the date of the beginning and 1 month of studies. So you suggest to see the posture of the human being from the other side. I see. I believe it's a very interesting new trend, and our symposium is for interdisciplinary cooperation, and in the very end we received a great presentation that enables us to move forward, to develop our work. Thank you very much. Any questions to the speaker? He hasn't left yet? Or not? Well, in fact, our scientific program is over. All the presentations were made. Perhaps if you have some questions to me, you're welcome. If not, let me congratulate my colleague, Professor Ivo Majek, who did a lot for this symposium. He did a lot of work. He was the chairman of many sessions and conducted excellently. Now we'll continue the practical part in our center. The scientific part is practically. Хотел бы поблагодарить всех участников за помощь, за то, что этот
DM was done interdisciplinary lectures and approaches to locomotor system. We listen to a lot of outstanding lectures from the different the directions on locomotor system. I hope that this is not the last symposium, and I am looking forward to the next meeting and symposium that we would like to prepare next year in autumn.
Дамы и господа, сейчас мы также организованно едем в наш центр, транспорт есть, в центр «Огонек», где сначала пообедаем, потом продолжим работу. Спасибо.